Hi, I'm Yannis Roussos from the Database Group, and I'd like to take you through what we are planning to achieve in GitLab 30.12, which is scheduled to be released on May 22nd of 2021. Our plan for 30.12 is to keep the same focus as in previous milestones. I'm going to try and keep this video as brief as possible. If you are interested in more details about anything, any of those features I'm going to discuss about, please follow the link that I'm going to post in the description of the video. And at the bottom of the issue, you can find links to past planning issues and videos with more details about its feature. So our top priority is addressing the primary key overflow risk for tables with an integer primary key. So we're tracking a few old tables that use a 4-byte integer for their primary key. Some of those have more than a billion records, and they are at risk of overflowing when they reach 2.15 billion records. So with the work we have done in 13.11, we now have a new architecture, a new framework that allows us to schedule background jobs over huge tables in a no downtime way. And at the same time, it allows us to tweak the settings of each job in real time. So what's very important for us is that we gather very granular statistics for each query that we run. Let's say, for example, that we have a job that runs 1,000 update queries. We track the execution time of each update, and then we can calculate aggregate statistics over each job or over batches of multiple jobs. So for example, here you can see for this job that it took 27 seconds to run, and it ran 150 queries, and with an average time 77 milliseconds per query, et cetera, et cetera. And what's important is that by having those statistics, we are now confident on tweaking the job. So for example, in this example here, we started with the events table. This is a table with 1.1 billion records. So we started by updating 15,000 records per 2 minutes. And then we started going up to 50,000, 75,000, until we settled at 200,000 records per job, per 2 minutes. What's important for us there is that in comparison with our current existing framework, we are using Rails migrations and scheduling them in Sidekick. We will have to schedule beforehand 100, 200,000 jobs, and it will take end-to-end something between 30 to 45 days. With this new approach, we were able to achieve the same goal in 11 days, which is a 3 to 4 times more faster than the existing way we are doing migrations. But more importantly, we never affected how our production environment worked. We were always sure that our queries were below a threshold. Even more impressive is after we were done with the events table, we converted the push event payloads table, and we tweaked it to update 1 million records per 2 minutes. So we were able to update 750 million records in less than 3 days, which is amazing. So in 30.12, we're going to continue with converting tables. We're now going to focus on the CI tables. The CI tables are all those tables behind the CI pipelines. So although some of those have a primary key that is at risk, and a lot of others reference tables with a primary key at risk. So we have to convert all those primary keys and foreign keys. There are some really big tables there. Our largest one has 5.4 billion records in GitLab.com. So we're going to start addressing more and more of those tables. But in addition to that, there are some tables that have both a primary key at risk and a foreign key towards a table that is at risk. So in order to move forward, our top priority from a tooling perspective is to update our existing migration framework to support converting multiple columns in a single migration. So updating, going through a table that has a primary key that you want to convert and 2 foreign keys, 3 columns, instead of going 3 times through that table, which is too expensive if you have to go through 1 billion records, going once and updating all of them at once. Our second priority is to add whatever is necessary to be able to safely run those migrations in self-hosted environments, in self-hosted instances. So we want to add monitoring capabilities, like, for example, adding the ability to track those migrations on the admin panel for background jobs, tooling and documentation to pause and restart such jobs, etc. So that's it for the primary key migrations. Our second priority is partitioning the workbook logs table. So this is also a pretty large table. It is more than a terabyte in size in GitLab.com. So in 30.11, what we did was we created the partition table. You cannot, in no downtime way, or in general, partition an existing table. What you have to do is create a new partition table with all the partitions. We're doing monthly partitioning here, and then copy all the data to the partitions before you can swap them. So in 30.11, we created the partitions, backfilled 1 terabyte of data, and we are now adding also indexes and foreign key, any remaining indexes and foreign keys. We are not adding the indexes and the foreign keys beforehand because they add an overhead while you copy data, because you know the indexes must be updated, the foreign keys must be validated. So we are done with that. In 30.12, if everything goes as planned, we are going to switch the tables. So starting 13.12, webhook logs will be a partition table. Finally, our last top priority is the database migration testing using production clones. So this is in GitLab.com. This is something, a feature we are dogfooding right now. It allows us for whenever we have a database migration, an update to the database or a data migration, like the ones I was describing above, we can run a CI pipeline and test with a production clone that is no more than an hour back. This is this feature has seen a wide adoption in GitLab.com and has proved to be a very valuable tool for all of GitLab engineering. So it has helped us test complex migrations like the ones we were discussing before, spot problems early, and in general gain confidence with respect to the behavior of hard to predict operations. So we're super excited about this. It has been very helpful to us, especially as we are trying to address and migrate huge tables. And we are starting to release the ability to use the feature to all of GitLab's engineering. And we are starting to think about how could we make it available to a larger community in a year or so. And in 13.12, we're going to wrap up our development efforts and add more features and reports for this feature. So that's it. Those were the major items we're working on. Thank you for watching, and talk to you in a month.